Hello students, I am Swarnalatha Sharma. I shall be teaching you the chapter integrals. In this chapter, we shall discuss the following points. First, introduction. Second, integration as an inverse process of differentiation. Third, methods of integration. Fourth, integrals of some particular functions. Fifth, integration by partial fractions. Sixth, integration by parts. Seventh, definite integral. Eighth, fundamental theorem of calculus. Ninth, evaluation of definite integrals by substitution. And 10th, some properties of definite integrals. Dear students, during the course of study of mathematics, you must have come across several pairs of inverse operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, forming an equation whose roots are given, solving a given equation, and so on. Integration and differentiation are also a pair of inverse operations. So far, from a given function, we have been finding its derivative, but the question arises, what is the function whose derivative is known? If the derivative of a function is given, then the function itself is called antiderivative or integral or primitive of the given function. We can illustrate it with the help of an example. Consider the function f of x is equal to x to the power 4, then its derivative is given by f dash x is equal to 4x cube. The question arises, given f dash x is equal to 4x cube, what is f of x? However, from our experience of derivatives, we can say f of x is equal to x to the power 4. The function x to the power 4 is an antiderivative or integral or primitive of 4x cube. Yet another question arises, is x to the power 4 the only function whose derivative is 4x cube? No, since the derivative of each of x to the power 4 plus 3, x to the power 4 minus 5, x to the power 4 plus 2 root 3, x to the power 4 minus 2 plus root 3 plus 5 pi is 4x cube. Every one of these have an equal claim to be an integral or antiderivative of 4x cube. Thus, if we know one integral, say x to the power 4 of the given function 4x cube, then we know many others. In fact, all functions of the form x raised to 4 plus c, where c is any real number, are integrals or antiderivatives of 4x cube, and there are no others. For if f of x and g of x are two functions such that f dash x is equal to g dash x, then they differ only by a real constant number, that is g of x is equal to f of x plus c, an application of Lagrange's mean value theorem. That is written as integral of 4x cube dx is equal to x to the power 4 plus c. This leads to if d by dx of f of x is equal to f of x, then integral of f of x dx is equal to f of x plus c. The function f of x is called antiderivative or integral or primitive of the function f of x, and c is called constant of integration or arbitrary constant. The function f of x is called the integrand, x is called the variable of integration, f of x dx is called the element of integration, and the symbol integral stands for the integral sign. The process of finding functions whose derivative is given is called antidifferentiation or integration. Since the integral of a function is not unique, that is definite, therefore it is called indefinite integral. In integral calculus, we come across two types of problems. Firstly, the problem of finding a function whose derivative is given. Secondly, the problem of finding the area bounded by the graph of a function under given conditions. These two problems lead to two forms of integrals, indefinite integrals and definite integrals, which together form the integral calculus. The two types of integrals, that is indefinite integrals and definite integrals, are connected by fundamental theorem of integral calculus, which make the definite integrals as a practical tool for science, engineering and many other disciplines like economics and probability, etc. Now students, we shall see integration as an inverse process of differentiation. Integration is the inverse process of differentiation. Instead of differentiating a function, we are given the derivative of a function and asked to find its primitive, that is the original function. Such a process is called integration. Let us consider the following example. We know that d by dx of sin x is equal to cos x, d by dx of x cube upon 3 is equal to x square, and d by dx of e to the power x is equal to e to the power x. We observe that the function cos x is the derived function of sin x. We say that sin x is an antiderivative or an integral of cos x. Similarly, x cube upon 3 and e to the power x are the antiderivatives or integrals of x square and e to the power x respectively. Again, we note that for any real number c treated as constant function, its derivative is 0, and hence we can write as follows. Again, we note that for any real number c treated as constant function, its derivative is 0, and hence we can write as follows. D by dx of sin x plus c is equal to cos x, d by dx of x cube upon 3 plus c is equal to x square, and d by dx of e to the power x plus c is equal to e to the power x. Thus, antiderivatives or integrals of the cited functions are not unique. Actually, there exist infinitely many antiderivatives of each of these functions, which can be obtained by choosing c arbitrarily from the set of real numbers. For this reason, c is customarily referred to as arbitrary constant. In fact, c is the parameter by varying which one gets different antiderivatives or integrals of the given functions. More generally, if there is a function f such that d by dx of f of x is equal to f x for every x belonging to I interval, then for any arbitrary real number c, also called constant of integration, d by dx of f of x plus c is equal to f of x, x belonging to I. Thus, f plus c, where c belongs to R, denotes a family of antiderivatives of f. Now, let us look at the notation. Given that dy by dx is equal to f of x, we write y is equal to integral f of x dx. Here, we have a list of symbols, terms and phrases with their meanings. Integral f of x dx means integral of f with respect to x. F x in integral f x dx means integrand. X in integral f of x dx means variable of integration. To integrate means to find the integral, and integral of f means a function f such that f dash x is equal to f of x. Integration means the process of finding the integral, and constant of integration means any real number c considered as constant function. We already know the formulae for the derivatives of many important functions. From these formulae, we can write down immediately the corresponding formulae referred to as standard formulae for the integrals of these functions as listed, which will be used to find integrals of other functions. Here, we have some integrals, that is antiderivatives. First, integral x to the power n dx is equal to x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 plus c, where n is not equal to minus 1. Second, integral dx is equal to x plus c. Third, integral cos x dx is equal to sin x plus c. Fourth, integral sin x dx is equal to minus cos x plus c. Fifth, integral sec square x dx is equal to tan x plus c. Sixth, integral of cos x square x dx is equal to minus cot x plus c. Seventh, integral sec x tan x dx is equal to sec x plus c. Eighth, integral cosec x cot x dx is equal to minus cosec x plus c. Ninth, integral dx upon square root of 1 minus x square is equal to minus cos inverse x plus c. Tenth, integral dx upon square root of 1 minus x square is equal to sin inverse x plus c. 11th, integral of dx upon 1 plus x square is equal to tan inverse x plus c. 12th, integral of dx upon 1 plus x square is equal to minus cot inverse x plus c. 13th, integral of dx upon x into square root of x square minus 1 is equal to sec inverse x plus c. 14th, integral dx upon x into square root of x square minus 1 is equal to minus cosec inverse x plus c. 15th, integral of e to the power x dx is equal to e to the power x plus c. 16th, integral of 1 upon x dx is equal to log of mod x plus c. 17th, integral of a to the power x dx is equal to a to the power x upon log a plus c. In practice, we normally do not mention the interval over which the various functions are defined. However, in any specific problem, one has to keep in mind. Now, let us discuss some properties of indefinite integral. First, the process of differentiation and integration are inverse of each other in the sense of the following results. D by dx of integral f of x dx is equal to f of x, and integral f dash x dx is equal to f of x plus c, where c is any arbitrary constant. Second, two indefinite integrals with the same derivative lead to the same family of curves, and so they are equivalent. Third, integral of f of x plus g of x dx is equal to integral of f of x dx plus integral g of x dx. Fourth, for any real number k, integral of k into f of x dx is equal to k into integral f of x dx. Fifth, properties 3 and 4 can be generalized to a finite number of functions f 1, f 2, f n and the real numbers k 1, k 2, k n, giving integral k 1 into f 1 x plus k 2 into f 2 x plus k n f n x dx is equal to k 1 into integral f 1 x dx plus k 2 into integral f 2 x dx plus k n into integral f n x dx. So, students, today we introduce ourselves to the chapter integrals, and we also discussed about the process of differentiation and integration as inverse of each other. In the next session, we shall study about the methods of integration. Thank you.